Hey guys, NCS Fan 001 here. Welcome you to another one of those trophy list analysis videos. So, today's game is Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, which as far as I know is going to be the first Call of Duty since Black Ops 2 to only be on one console, which is really good. Stop putting them on two different consoles, hopefully. Anyway, this is obviously PS4 only then. It is 51 total trophies worth 1,185 points. The trophies are broken up into 1 platinum, 1 gold, 12 silver, and 37 bronze. If I counted correctly, it's either 10 or 11 are zombies, 1 is multiplayer, and all the others are campaign. So, follows the typical Infinity Ward trend. God, they sound so similar. Anyway, let's get to it. Okay, so our platinum trophy is just called platinum, so that's our typical platinum trophy. So we have a whole bunch of bronzes here. Again, this sort of follows the typical Infinity Ward and even Call of Duty trend that we've gotten kind of used to. So we have Rising Threat, Complete Rising Threat, Black Sky, Complete Black Sky, and I'm not going to repeat the full thing for each of these because it's one of those where the trophy name is basically the same thing as the trophy description. Operation Port Armor, complete that operation. Operation Burn Water, Operation Dark Quarry, Operation Black Flag, and Operation Bloodstorm complete those various operations. So the way I'm reading that is that operations are the campaign missions, but they may be able to be done in like different orders and such from everything I can tell from this campaign. It looks like they're all going to be available to do in different orders. So that will actually be kind of cool if that's true, that you can kind of do them out of order, or maybe like it's even more like Black Ops 2 where they sort of build on each other. You have to do one mission to get to another, sort of like that. That would actually be really kind of cool if they did that. Here's our first gold trophy, The Longest Day. Complete all single player missions on Veteran. Excuse me, the only gold trophy, I believe. Sorry about that. The Longest Day, complete all single-player missions on Veteran. As we know, Veteran is generally not that hard in Infinity War games. At least, it's not usually as bad as some of the Treyarch games, and Veteran is our highest difficulty this time around. So as long as there's nothing really like Mile High Club, we'll be okay. Now we have a bunch more operations. Taken Dagger, Phoenix, Operation Decon, Operation Deep Execute. Those are all presumably more story missions, or some of them may also be side missions. I would assume that's probably going to be part of it, because if they aren't all, if they're all story missions, then that means this could actually be a very long story, which is a good thing. You know, it would be kind of nice to see Call of Duty try to get a really good story going again, because it's been a while since I feel like we've really had one. So you never know, maybe it will be a good long story with a lot of missions to it. Targets of Opportunity, this is our first silver. Complete all shipboarding side missions. So side missions, I have heard about that. There's going to be a few different types of them. Operation Safe Harbor and Operation Pure Threat. Complete those operations. We're going back to bronzes with those. Operation Grave Robber. Complete that operation. Operation Sudden Death. Operation Trace Kill. Complete those operations. So again, I would assume that probably not all of these are going to be required to complete the game. Not all these are going to be required to complete the, at least the story portion. Hopefully, it might even be slightly open world or something, which I don't think it will be, but that would actually be really cool if they give you a little more variability again with choosing the missions you want to do when you want to do them. Here we have another silver, Top Gun, complete all Jackal-only side missions. So the Jackal is the fighter vehicle thingy that you have, whatever you want to call it, Starship, whatever the heck it is. New Gun Collector, scan your first weapon. Serious Gun Collector, scan 10 weapons. And another silver here, Gun Nut, all weapons scanned. So I assume that's something to do with how you obtain different weapons in the game. That's what I assume. Or maybe that's actually a type of collectible. It could be that's like a type of collectible and you have to scan the weapons to be able to use them in custom loadouts. And that's one of the two or three types of collectibles for this game. I guess we'll see. I'm not entirely sure about that, though. And then we have Peace to the Fallen. Listen to all of the Death Letters of the Fallen. That's another silver. So Death Letters of the Fallen are apparently one of the collectible types for this game. Maybe the only type, maybe one of multiple types. I guess we'll see yet again. Back to bronzes here. Make it personal. Load out with a custom weapon. That should be very easy. Gear up. Find your first equipment upgrade. That should be very easy. Fully equipped, that's a silver, earn all equipment upgrades. So I'm wondering if you have to, like, if you just buy them in some way, or if you actually have to find them as collectibles. Because if so, that would actually be really, really cool if they do that, to have these as extra collectibles. Then again, I'm not a big fan of large numbers of collectibles in games, so again, we'll find out. Fangs out. Come on, guys, you should have put Harambe after that. Rip Harambe, rest in peace. Fangs out, earn your first Jackal item, weapon or upgrade, and then Jackal Ace, earn all Jackal weapons and upgrades. So again, either collectibles or maybe you earn them by doing certain things within the game. Probably nothing too difficult on those unless they come from some kind of challenges. That's the one thing I haven't really seen on here is if there are challenges or accolades the way that Black Ops 2 and Black Ops 3 did it. Ante up, get your first kill on the Most Wanted board, Ace is high, clear half of the Most Wanted board. Wow, you had to steal that from Mercenaries 2. Great job, guys. And Royal Flush, all SDF aces and captains killed for a silver. So now that's actually really interesting because, like I was just sort of saying there, that really is actually very reminiscent of Mercenaries and Mercenaries 2 when you had the deck of 52, especially in Mercenaries 1. So more so that game than Mercenaries 2. That would actually be really, really cool if they do that, because that's going to be very reminiscent of those old games. And I don't know, like I said, it would be very neat if we see that, if we have like a full HVT list and you go on specific missions to go hunt them down and stuff. That would actually be really cool, and I'll give them credit if they actually do that. Okay, so now we get to the various miscellaneous trophies of the game. We have a couple of silvers. Danger close, kill 15 enemies with a 0G grappling hook. You know nothing. Kill Koch before his speech ends. Now that is just freaking stupid that you would spoil that in the trophy list. Maybe that's a secret trophy, I don't know. But he's the freaking main antagonist. Why would you spoil that for us, like, right here? Oh well, I don't know, like, why you would put that exactly in that. You could have just said, kill a certain enemy before he finishes his speech, because he's the main antagonist. Now we get back to bronzes. Captain's log, use the computer in the captain's office. Reality TV, watch a newscast. Boots on the ground, go 2 minutes without double jumping or wall running in a mission where these abilities are available. So now they're literally rewarding us for not doing what they put as the main thing in the game. That's just strange. I don't know. Peekaboo, kick open a door, peek open a door, and throw a grenade while peeking a door. What the hell does that even mean? Gravity kills. Kill an enemy while floating in your own anti-gravity grenade. That should be fun. C12. Okay, again, kill a C12 by doing a right rodeo, a left rodeo, and by blowing off multiple limbs. Again, what the hell does that even mean? Seriously, some of these trophies make absolutely no freaking sense whatsoever compared to other Call of Duty games. Then again, in their commercial, they basically said, screw it, let's go to space. And I'm pretty sure that sums up this entire game's design. Just take Black Ops 3 and put it in space. No creativity whatsoever. Okay, so now we're actually getting to the other trophies for, mostly for the zombies mode. So the zombies is zombies in Spaceland, and let's get to those trophies. The first two are silvers. Sticker Collector, in Spaceland, find all the quest items and complete the sticker pack. I assume that is the Easter egg or, like, the main goal of the level. As well as this next trophy, Soul Key. In Spaceland, recover the piece of the Soul Key. So I assume that those are both related to the Easter egg for the map, or the main objective for the map to complete it. So I'm sure we'll see NGT zombies and some of them out there working on that from day one, because they've said they are excited for it. At least Spider did. The bigger they are, we're getting back to bronze. In Spaceland, defeat 5 brutes in 1 game without dying. That could be a bit challenging, depending on what weapons you have and how tough they are, especially if they're like Brutus from the Mob of the Dead. Hoff the Charts. In Spaceland, unlock David Hasselhoff. I assume you have to beat the Easter egg or whatever to get that. But that shouldn't be too bad once we have guides out for it. Hopefully it won't be. Rock on. In Spaceland, craft a weapon of rock. Okay, then. Oh, wait, rock. I get it. So it's like something related to like a guitar or something. That's actually kind of cool. Get packed. In Spaceland, pack a punch a weapon. Batteries not included. In Spaceland, create an exquisite core. I love the 80s. In Spaceland, find the Modern Warfare 1 and 2 songs. Okay, that's kind of cool, I guess. Insert coin. In Spaceland, play every arcade game at least once. So I wonder if you have to find quarters to play them. I know I've seen that before in the trailers. I'm not entirely sure how it works, though. Our last silver trophy, Braindead, in Spaceland. Play 30 games, so 30 games of Spaceland, I assume, and get to scene 10 or higher. So that's referring to the fact that it's supposed to be like a movie trailer, or like a movie almost. So I assume that means maybe play 30 games and either get far through the map or just survive 10 rounds. I don't know exactly. But since it's a silver, I assume it's going to be harder than just survive 10 rounds and play 30 games. I feel like that's fairly simple. And our final trophy is our only multiplayer trophy, Dominion. Win 5 online matches in multiplayer. So thankfully, we don't have to spend much time in the actual multiplayer because I did not enjoy it and I don't really plan to play it at all. So looking at this trophy list, it looks fairly similar to other Infinity Ward trophy lists. It's mostly campaign with a few trophies, like a fifth of the trophies in co-op, and one for multiplayer. So my assumption is it's going to be very similar in overall difficulty, probably to Ghosts, because that's the more recent, and because Ghosts is, Ghosts is really easy aside from Extinction Mode, and I feel like zombies could be fairly tough in this game. I doubt the campaign will be that tough. It never really is in Infinity Ward games, at least it hasn't been for a while. So I'm going to put the tentative difficulty at around a 5 out of 10, so sort of right in the middle. But I will put the time up a little bit higher at 30 to 50 hours, depending on how long it takes to get some of this stuff done. So, hope you guys enjoy the video. Infinite Warfare drops on November 4th, so about 2 weeks away. And that is actually on my fall break, which is pretty awesome. So I'll have my entire fall break to play it. Then again, I'll probably be playing more Battlefield than any, or actually, no, not even Battlefield, Call of Duty 4 Remastered, because that's all I care about. So, hope you guys enjoyed the video. See you next time.